So if you've seen my past videos, like the Goodbye Harvard and the Getting to Berlin video, you know that these little clips that I take of my life, they mean a lot to me. So I've been thinking a lot about how best to store the footage that you take in your life so that later you can incorporate it and actually see it and use it. So I don't know if this is how it is for you, but for me, before I reorganized things, I had all my photos for my whole life, either in my camera roll, on my computer, or they were on my social media account. And whenever I needed to go back and find a video or a photo, I would go through everything to find what I need, whether it's someone's birthday, whether it's my parents' anniversary, or anything. And so when I made the Goodbye Harvard video, I used this process to go back through everything to find all the clips that meant something to me. If you haven't seen the Goodbye Harvard video, it's a reflective piece where I use a whole bunch of my prior footage. And to go through everything, it took me like around 4 weeks, which is fine during quarantine, but it took me 4 weeks to go through everything to find everything I needed for a 4-minute video. And so that's like not sustainable if I'm gonna keep, you know, making videos like this. Like, I needed a better way to be able to organize this footage. All right, so the first thing I did was I exported all my photos from all those places I mentioned earlier. And after I exported them, I needed to get an external hard drive because my computer didn't have enough memory for everything. And so the type I got, I'll leave a link in the description below. But so anyways, this is looking inside what the main folder of that hard drive looks like. And so going, starting from the top here, what this footage library is it's literally a collection of all the footage from my life. This is all the photos and videos. The footage inbox, this is essentially all the footage that I have taken with my camera. I store it here before I give it a tag. So I'll go into what that tagging system looks like in a second. The project files, these are all the files that I use when I'm actually creating a video, like the one I'm doing right now. This video, I have a whole bunch of, you can see, all these project files here. So everything I use to actually make the video. Below I have a sound library. And so basically that's not very built out yet, but in the future as I download music that I wanna use in my videos, I'll keep that there. And the media library is rather unrelated, but it's just books and other things. So not totally related to how I store my photos and videos. So going to the top here to the footage library, if I go in, I see the first one is 2020 postgrad. So this is the year. And I have another external hard drive, which has all my footage from different years from my prior years. So 2018, 2019 is when I really started taking a lot of footage. And then over here, you see everything divided by month. And so everything has a month. So 5, 6, 7, you know, and then it also has the title of the photo shoot or the place that I was when I did it. So if you can see, I have all of this footage from being at home. And then I have a lot of footage from like San Francisco. And then it goes to LA and then ultimately to Berlin. And so let me go to one of these randomly, maybe like the Venice Beach one. Here you see all the footage that I took when I was on Venice Beach doing one morning when I was in LA. And for every single clip, I've given it a tag as well. And I don't know if I learned that you can actually do this in the Finder window. You can give everything a tag. And so for example, I'm talking about Casey Neistat in this one, so that's why I give him a tag. It's in Venice Beach, it's a vlog, it's Los Angeles. And I do this for every one of my, for every one of the videos in here. It's more of an art than a science, but in general, I just try to give all the tags that are relevant to the clip, often where the clip is taken, and also if there's any content that I talk about in the clip. And the idea is to create a whole bunch of tags that over time will have some sort of value, and then later I can organize by the tag itself. So if I go type in Marty in here, and I see the tag for Marty, I can see all the clips that I have where I either talk about Marty or Marty is in them. Which is of course great. And it's actually been super helpful for me in my videos. And if you remember the soccer shot I had from my last video, this is something that this organization structure has really allowed me to do because I knew I wanted to create this shot over a whole bunch of periods of time. And so I added the tag soccer to all of them. And then I was able later to stitch them all together and make it all look like one continuous story, which is really cool. And the big question at the end of the day, the most important question is it worth it? Is it worth giving so much of your time to be able to create this type of resource for yourself? And the answer for me is yes, because making these videos has been awesome. It's been like a great way to reflect on my experience. and, you know, really feel more connected with the people that I love in my life. And so creating this resource has been a really helpful way for me to make my videos and create that sort of synthesis. So for sure, it's been helpful for me. And I've currently done it for these life moments, you know, moving to Berlin. I've done it for graduating. And I only imagine what it's going to be later in my life when I have these other great life milestones that I get to commemorate through video. And the last cool thing is that I've found by having this library, it actually allows me to live differently. Like it, I take more photos, I take more videos because I know that they're going to be in this place that I can return to them. And it's not that I take more intrusive videos, like I ruin the moments of my life, but I just take these little clips like walking into my apartment for the first time, like when I'm saying goodbye to a friend. And I know that these things are going to work their way back into the videos I create. And I'm really excited about what that's going to look like in my future. So I hope this video, I hope it's been helpful to you. I hope you've learned something if you were looking for that. I'm really just wondering and thinking about this problem. And if you have any things that I'm sure I can learn from as well, please let me know in the comments or reach out to me. I'm really keen to hear if there's a better way for me to do what I'm talking about today. Thanks for watching again, and have a good one.